Hey, I'm Chad with Ambic. I'd like to introduce you to one of our technology partners that we've been working with for quite some time, who fits in really well with our core messaging about AI on the edge. So without further ado, Joshua, do you want to introduce yourself and tell us a little bit about your company?
My name is Joshua Buck. I work with Edge Impulse. Part of the solution engineering team, and we're very working with customers every day to bring AI applications into production. Edge Impulse is a platform for making models, and which it's an end-to-end platform. So you can actually collect data, train your models, and deploy to targets like the Ambic Apollo series, which we fully integrated into our platform. And our really key goal is to make it very easy to use and make sure that these models can get to production quickly. The easier it is for the developer, the easier it is we can get out to production.
Wonderful. Yeah, and I understand your value for Ambic is that you're really helping us scale. We have our own AI team, we're developing our own models in-house, but we're limited in terms of our resource constraints in terms of our ability to support large volumes of customers. So I think that's really one of your areas of expertise, right? Is going kind of mass market with
Absolutely, right? So Edge Impulse being a platform that's online for disability to collect data and train models, right? We work with your teams who may want to, you know, have their key select accounts that they're really working for and want to support, right? And we definitely support that mass market because we offer a tool that's very easy to use. And then we also provide the support for that tooling as well, right? And we work with a number of partners out there, of which Ambic's a very key part of that ecosystem play.
Great. Mm-hmm. So you talked about your tool chain. Can you talk a little bit about your business model? How do our joint end customers engage with Edge Impulse and Ambic?
Sure. So you can kind of think of my team and how I work with you as trying to get the road paved for our mutual end customer, right?
Sure.
So when you have customers who are looking to develop AI applications, okay, and need that getting point to get started, right, Edge Impulse offers a free tier of development. So that can quickly get started on the Apollo, Ambic Apollo series, right?
Yes.
And then when they decide to move into commercial applications, we have different tiers of plans that we can use for enterprise type licensing, right? But for most part, a lot of our development that we want you to try and get started with and make sure that you can see what the art of what's possible out there with AI, Edge AI applications.
Wonderful. Mm-hmm. Several months ago, we launched together our Apollo 4 Plus series, which is a Cortex M4F mm-hmm. core running at 192 megahertz, and it's capable of running a wide variety of AI algorithms. It's been shipping in wearables for a few years now, running AI workloads for health heuristics, for motion, for sleep analysis, out on the edge. So now that same platform has been brought up inside of the Edge Impulse ecosystem. So now it has access to tremendous amounts of AI algorithms in your portfolio.
Absolutely. So all those applications that you talked about, right, like health wearables and vision and use cases, you absolutely can do on the Ambic Apollo series, right? Those customers work very closely with you to get those products launched, right? And we bring those same kind of learnings out to the mass market with the Edge Impulse platform. Right.
Wonderful.
And so we definitely work with the dev kit. You can buy a dev kit today, right, on your distributors. And we integrated the sensors on those dev kits and make it very easy to get started with AI applications on Edge Impulse with the Ambic series.
Wonderful.
Ambic Apollo series.
Yeah. So I understand that our AI team has been working with you on our latest Apollo 510.
Yes.
Which we're showing here at the show. We won Best in Show at Embedded World in 2024 in the hardware category with that part. And now this year, using some of our own AI, we won Best in Show in the AI category with our heart kit, where we're doing some heart health analysis with PPG and ECG data, doing parallel denoising, segmentation of the ECG data, and then the final analysis of that data to determine if there's any specific heart conditions. So we're doing that all on Apollo 510. It's also very capable of running on Apollo 4F on the Cortex M4. With 510, it has the Cortex M55 Helium Vector Math Acceleration Engine, which acts as an AI coprocessor, and it runs so much more efficiently, and it's just wonderful. We're really, really happy about that. So where are we at with the 510 in terms of your ecosystem?
Yeah, so I was just working with my team this morning on the latest on that integration. They'll be coming out soon, right? And it'll have the same kind of support that we have with the Apollo 4 series.
Fantastic.
Today, right? And those type of applications, particularly in the wearables market, the ECG, the health wearables market, like the heart monitoring, the PPG application, those kind of things, you absolutely can do with Edge Impulse as well. Again, part of that mass market, like, let's make this development easier for everybody.
Oh, that's really wonderful. Great. An Edge Impulse FOMO algorithm, fast object, moving object, that we've trained on faces, and we'll show you what face detection looks like running on the Apollo 510 with a kind of early implementation of your platform on our latest silicon. That's just ramping into production now.
Indeed, yeah. I'd love to show off more about that demo, and we'll be happy to provide more information if anybody has it. So head over to edgeimpulse.com, obviously nbic.com, for your latest edge AI needs.
Yeah, fantastic. Well, thanks so much, Josh, for coming here.
Thank you.
Yeah, enjoy the discussion.
All right, appreciate it.